You're late.
Don't just live life, maxify it.
India are batting first, but here's a question, Claire. Lizzie, you mentioned she's not there, and Nadine de Klerk has come in, Sunilis has come in, no Ayabonga Khata as well. But Lizzie, look at the numbers, 288 runs in this series, four games, an average of 144 in four ODIs, and people say that she's the one match wonder or so, because one impact innings is what she on an average plays in a series. But this series has changed it all, and that strike rate is also not bad. 86.22, and the second is Poonam Raut, India's best, 253. But look at that gap, and the impact, as I say, is clearly on Lizelle Lee's side. So will South Africa miss that when they come out to field also? Because remember, she's good in that backward point region, manning that area, diving around at even mid-off, etc. So how big a miss would Lizelle Lee's absence be for South Africa?
You know, obviously it is going to be a loss for South Africa, but I think it's a worthwhile experimentation, and it's a worthwhile rest for her. She's been fantastic. And I've always been a fan and a supporter of her, but it's just like, for me, something has never quite clicked with her. She's got this aggressive ability, but at times she almost lets her mind wander, and she just falls on the fact that she's got such good hands and such good eyes, and then the technique doesn't quite follow that. And we all know that, you know, good hands, good eyes can only get you so far. And then the bowlers start to figure you out. And for me, after that first ODI against Pakistan, where she went out playing across the line, it was like a penny drop for her. And she came back in that second ODI against Pakistan. And you could see, I mean, my impression was she probably spent about 10 or 12 hours in the nets over a two-day period to correct that technical issue. And she absolutely nailed it. And technically, from that second ODI against Pakistan, she has been a phenomenal player. And we can actually see the consistency coming through in her. And that's only, for me, been the issue around her performance for South Africa. We know she can win matches for South Africa. We know she's a phenomenal batsman, and she has the massive ability to score really, really quickly. But you don't want her doing that 1 in 8. You need her doing that 1 in 3. And I'm also not talking about necessarily having to go out and getting 80s and 100s, but your opening partnership, sticking together and getting over that 100 mark. We see when that happens, the kind of success you get both in the women's game and in the men's game. So for me, she really has been a class act, that when you know you've got a problem, you really put your mind to it. And you correct that issue. And she's just been fantastic this series. So, yes, South Africa will miss her. And the opening partnership for South Africa has been very, very successful at the moment. But South Africa also need to understand who else can step into those shoes. What happens if we have an injury? What happens if we have an illness? Like we've seen Laura Wolfart having to step up and captain the side, because both Danae and Sine were out for, you know, obviously Danae for injury and Sine for illness. And that's what you've got to prepare yourself for the whole time in international cricket, because you just don't know what's going to happen.